How worried are you about Lamar Jackson and the Ravens offense?
Well, you'd have to be worried because their passing offense is not impressive. Overall, as a team, you know, they're still pretty damn good and obviously exceptionally well coached. But Lamar Jackson and that passing game have got to get their act together. Now, obviously, it seems ideal that if you're going up against the Patriots, that would be a prime opponent to fix whatever ails you, because they've got so many things going on within that organization right now, defensively in terms of bodies being available, offensively in terms of the inability to pass the football effectively and to be a real significant threat offensively. All of those things you've got to concern yourself with. But in the end, if the Ravens are going to make noise come playoff time, they've got to get their passing attack together. You know that they're going to win more than their share of regular season games with Lamar Jackson as their quarterback, because he's so electrifying as an athlete and his running ability. But this is about being able to throw the football. And I think that's the one concern that no one can ignore. And we're not going to ignore. We're not going to look past until we see him show that he can do that, particularly come playoff time.
Yes, Lamar Jackson has to get to be a better passer. He started off his career in a promising way. The trajectory has not taken him to the place you'd hope he'd be at the moment. But am I worried about the offense? I don't think it's an X's and O's, can Lamar Jackson be a pocket passer thing for them to have success. I never have thought it's that about this team. Look, they just beat the Colts. How'd the Colts look last night? Colts are good. They beat the Colts. Yes, they kept them to 10 points, but they hung 24 on them. No, Lamar Jackson has no problem beating good teams, excellent teams. In fact, he did it last year. Again, take six games out where the lights shone brightest. He's 25-1. 25-1 against the rest of the league. Plenty of good wins. Plenty of high-scoring games. They dropped almost 40 points on the Browns. Browns are pretty good week one. No, they can score. The offense is okay. That's not the issue. You can't make excuses like that, I don't think, if you're the Ravens. The problem is they can't beat the teams they need to beat. If you're in the AFC, you must beat the Chiefs. They're 0-3. If you're the Ravens, you must beat the Steelers. With Roethlisberger, they're 0-1. Obviously, you have to win in the playoffs. They're 0-2. Lamar Jackson, his issue is coming through when the team needs him most under pressure. It is not, and I don't think ever has been, can he beat good teams? Can their offense score points? I believe the answer is yes, although I have to admit he's struggling this year in terms of his development. You thought he would develop, at least I did, continue his development this year. That hasn't happened. I'm not worried about the offense, Stephen A. I'm worried about not even between the ears. I don't think Lamar Jackson doesn't know how to play the position. But I mean that the way I was questioning things about Clayton Kershaw and James Harden. Can you win when you need to? That's the issue for me with Lamar Jackson.
Well, that should be the issue. But, you know, again, and that's why I don't know how much we'll learn from this particular game, Max, because you have to remember the New England Patriots have the 25th ranked rushing defense. So you can run on the New England Patriots. And that's with just ordinary running backs, not a quarterback that you're wondering whether or not he's going to throw or run, but runs better than most running backs at the quarterback position in Lamar Jackson. So that's going to be very, very difficult. Remember, the Ravens got the number one rushing attack in football because Lamar Jackson is their quarterback and he's also their leading rusher. That was the same with them last year. Now, passing, they're ranked second to last. They've got to do something about that. You're the New England Patriots. You got 28th ranked offense. You got 28th ranked passing attack. You know what? Guess what? You're going to have to move the chains and keep these brothers off the field in order for you to have a chance to beat the Baltimore Ravens. You're Lamar Jackson. Again, we could see him do some things, but if he wins because he's running the football effectively and the Ravens are running the football effectively, and we never see him throw the football, then we're really not learning anything that we did not know. The Baltimore Ravens are the number one defense in the National Football League. They're eighth in yards surrendered, for crying out loud. But they're a top 10 defense in all the requisite categories, and they're number one overall in points allowed. And New England struggles to score. They're the 28th ranked offense. So I don't expect the Baltimore Ravens to lose this game. I don't expect the Baltimore Ravens not to be able to put up some points on the ground. What I'm looking to see is, can Lamar Jackson throw the football? Throw the football. And we really don't care even if he does it, because we want to see him do a composed season time.
Well, look, they played New England last year with Brady, and they played Seattle with Russell Wilson, and they played San Francisco, and they won all those games. They played Buffalo, who was starting to really come on. They won all those games, and they were always scoring 20
season
or more points. And but the regular season games, not their chief rivals, so to speak. And the offense works. You know, whatever you want to say, I agree. It would be nice to see him continue to progress as a passer, but they're able to score points, and they should be able to do it again against New England. I think people are reaching a little bit for excuses for Lamar, and I don't think we need to. I think he should be held to the same standard that other elite players, I mentioned Kershaw and James Harden, not just in football, but in other sports, because he's a transcendent talent who is almost undefeated, except when you need him most, in the NFL so far. Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.